The contest of the rattling die inside a plastic dome has gone down in a local comic shop in the corner on the island of Maui. And it all ends here, in a series of troublesome events through dies. Hello everyone, and welcome to the series of troublesome events through dice. I am Alex, and I am joined by my color commentator.
I am Xanadu Lopen, and boy, do we have a great game coming our way today. Isn't that right, Alex?
That's certainly right, Xanadu, but I gotta ask you, why are you wearing that shirt today?
It's casual day.
No, it's not.
Oh.
So, 12 contestants have been enrolled to see who the best player is by luck and skill through this very popular board game.
That's right, Alex. Everybody wants to take home that grand prize and make a name for themselves, with the prize being bragging rights.
And it all comes down to 4 contestants. We will see the final table in just a minute, but first, let's check out some highlights and see how we got to this conclusion. We begin with 4 separate preliminary bouts that were organized by our gaming commission.
That's right, Alex. All bouts were organized by the groups each player represents, which means that friends will have to fight against each other.
In the first bout, we had 2 personalities of the Rave Corner compete against each other. My brother Aaron goes against Daniel, aka Wimplo86.
I've always wanted to see this. 2 great friends turned enemies, but only for the sake of the game and bragging rights.
Unfortunately, this contest has never happened, as Wimplo failed to show up for this matchup. Here to cast his ruling on this incident is our commissioner. Let's get the official word.
In Section 1 of the Gaming Commission Acts, any player that has entered the tournament must do so as a tangible being. As such, Poltergeist, Ghost, Slimer, any other ethereal being or non-present entity has been deemed disqualified from gaming rules. As such, because of their failure to appear, contestant Wimplo86 is disqualified from the games.
Due to not showing up at the official matchup, Daniel has indeed been disqualified, and Aaron moves on to the finals.
This is truly a missed opportunity for Daniel, but I heard he has something to say on the issue. Isn't that right, Alex?
Yes, I'm getting notice of this too, so let's go down and see what he has to say.
What? I never heard about this. I would have played if I knew about it. Shenanigans.
Daniel, it's a shame that we couldn't see you compete this year, but hey, good luck, and we hope to see you again next year if you do receive an invitation.
Isn't that his invitation right there? Did you forget to mail it to him, Alex?
Absolutely not. In the second bout, we have the Friday Night Frights crew squaring off. Tony Midnight with Killer Cal in his corner took on Ali B and guests Al Jawa and Maui Mark.
Everyone brought their A game in this one, but I heard the game ended in a controversy.
You're certainly right, Xanadu. Let's go to the footage and see what happened.
4! 1, 2, 3, 4!
Ooh, nice one.
Oh, okay, I guess it's my turn.
4 again!
Oh,
you're coming up quick.
Ooh, I was winning! Come on!
2!
1, 2.
Damn. What's that over there?
Shocking. Absolutely shocking.
That's right, Alex. No one should ever try and physically harm another player. Shame on you all, Jawa. For shame.
You know, it's a good thing my brother Art was on hand as the official of that table.
Great job for Art, but why didn't he wear his uniform as an official?
Well, you see, his thing is that he shows up to work dressing very casually, and yet somehow he always gets away with it.
Yes, I see that, but I don't get it.
And yeah, let's just go with it.
Okay.
So, despite Tony Midnight's win, we are getting word that our commissioner has reviewed the footage and will now give his official ruling. Let's go ahead and see what he has to say.
Pursuant to the rules of the regulation as set forth by the commissioner, we have a multiple infraction here, part of one of the players, a gentleman by the name of Tony. He has violated not only subsection 5, appendix A, but several sections back, he has also went against the gaming statute, and that was the rules that the commissioner originally set up in spirit of making this a fun competition entirely. Now, as a result of Tony's violations, certain contestants got a little antsy, and due to violent, forcibly altercation that happened somewhere during the course of the game, it's kind of hard to tell. We're still going over the tapes. The whole team, until a ruling from the official commissioner, has been DQ'd.
The ruling has been made. Tony Midnight has been disqualified and the bout has been thrown out by our commissioner, which leaves one spot open.
Bad news for the FNFA, but great news for other contestants.
In the third bout, we have independent personalities of YouTube, Instagram, and other backgrounds squaring off. We have a showdown between Thomas, Marco, Jaren, and the House of Blues.
That's right, every contestant has been summoned, but I heard this match also had some mishaps that happened along the way.
You are right, Xanadu. Due to Tony Midnight's disqualification and by order of Commissioner Shaggy, this round was supposed to select the top two qualifiers to fill in two empty seats of the final table. However, we were told that two out of the four contestants did not show up and were promptly disqualified.
This is certainly shocking, Alex. What the heck is going on down there?
I'm being told Marco chose not to show up due to something going on at his home. Let's see what's happening there.
Hey, what's up, guys? I would love to beat all of you guys, but I went back home because I had a listing on eBay, you know, one of the grails that I've been wanting for a long time that I wanted to get this year. It's ending soon, and I'm about to win it. It's a 9-0 giant size X-Men 1. So, yeah, I'd rather, you know, concentrate on this than, you know, be with you guys. But, yeah, I'm about to win it right about now, man.
On top of tossing away a really good opportunity, it looks like he also lost his auction to Xanadu.
Good luck next time, Marco. I'll know you win.
Are you referring to the tournament or the auction?
Both.
Well, besides Marco, it looks like the House of Blues also could not make it today due to some sort of car trouble.
I can relate to that. Having car trouble isn't any fun, Alex.
Well, it looks like he did leave a comment about this issue. Let's see what he has to say about it.
How's the House of Blues here? You know, I got some unfortunate news. I was invited to the series of troublesome events through DICE. But I won't be making it today, guys. My car won't start due to someone pissing in the gas tank. And, you know, I don't know when I can get it fixed. But I hope I can join you guys in a future episode. I call shenanigans.
With two men out, Thomas and Jared now have a seat at the final round.
What a break for those two guys. I'm sure both of their confidence levels have risen higher.
No doubt, Xanadu. In our fourth bout, we have some familiar faces of Maui Comics and Collectibles. Scheduled for this round was a two-way battle between Alika and Swan the Warchief.
This was another anticipated bout of this tournament, and one that would have had people talking if it actually happened.
That's right, Xanadu. Alika was also disqualified for not being able to participate.
This is certainly unprecedented, Alex. Yet again, good news for those two who are still around.
It appears Alika chose not to play by choice and didn't seem to care when he lost.
Wow, this is the first time a contestant willingly threw away an opportunity like this without a care in the world.
You're right, Xanadu. We sent our filming crew to approach Alika for a comment, and here's what he said.
Alika, hey, I'm from the series of Troublesome Events. We're told that you actually got an invite, but you refused the invitation. Do you care to comment?
Well, look, I know one thing. The only way to stay out of trouble is to never touch that Pop-O-Matic bubble.
Alika has struck himself out, which means Swan moves on to the finals.
Congratulations to my brother Swan. I wish him good luck in the final round.
The final table has been set. This will be a four-way battle between Thomas, Swan the War Chief, Jaren, and Aaron.
I'm so excited for this match! Everyone has what it takes to win the grand prize.
We will move on to the final round in just a minute, but first our professional player analyst Joseph will give us a complete breakdown on all of our finalists.
Tonight, we got one event on a crickety table, trouble, not really trouble, no, really, just one little table. We've got four guys playing on four little pegs, four different colors, well, technically one for Swan, one. He can only see red, he's practically the new Cyclops. We got the Asian Morpheus Aaron, the Mr. Talented, the very silent, but the very cool. And we got the Silent Bob, but not so Silent Bob, comic shop owner. We got Swan in the one corner, and we got that one guy, Thomas, the token white guy with a little hat. He's always screaming, you're evil. But let's go on down tonight. And wait, did I forget? Yeah, there's one guy that actually looks like me. I keep thinking that he's looking in the mirror sometimes. But yes, going down one night, one event tonight.
Thank you for the info there, Joseph.
Insightful as always, great job.
Absolutely, and without further ado, let's move on to the final round. Here's Thomas, a big fan of Superman. He will be using the blue pegs. Xanadu's brother, Swan the War Chief of hashtag Encounters of the Nerdkind, and someone you meet often at Maui Comics and Collectibles, he will be using the red pegs.
You know, Alex, earlier today, Joseph reportedly seen Swan putting a bag of sugar in his trunk.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Here's Jaren of Jaren's Movie Reviews on Instagram. He will be using the green pegs. And my twin brother Aaron of the Rave Corner. He will be using the yellow pegs. Alright, so we begin the game by having each player roll a die. And whoever has the highest number, that person will go first. And then the players will be taking turns in a clockwise motion. So it looks like right now, Jaren has a 2, Aaron has a 4, which means Swan goes first. Now, Xanadu, who do you think is gonna win in this game?
Whoever isn't the gray piece.
Oh, you poor thing. I. Can you at least see Swan's red pigs on the board?
Actually, I do. And you know what? I hope he goes last.
Harsh words coming from Xanadu. Swan gets a 4. And then, oh, right off the bat, Jaren gets a 6 and he gets to go again. And then, what do you know, Xanadu? It's another 6. Swan is trying to play some mind games. I think it's working there, Xanadu. What do you think?
I think he's a chump.
It's bad enough that he has to be briefed in into this game. He didn't know that he had to move again after every 6. So right there, we have all players. They're unable to move since none of them got the 6 yet. And Jaren gets another 2.
They're loving these 2s, I see.
And, wow, Aaron gets a 5. Right now, we really got a slow start. I really don't know when this game will pick up just yet. Thomas can't seem to hide his disappointment there, Xanadu.
Oh, please go in front of me. Please go in front of me. Please go in front of me.
Cursing Jaren, I see there.
Aaron's got the 4, still can't move.
He's going to go on 4 just because he went on it. I see.
Now, I did mention before that Thomas is the biggest Superman fan. I just realized right now, Xanadu, that he is blazing a Superman wristwatch. A really nice touch on him, I might add.
What is this, a fashion show or a trouble game? Get with it.
Let's shake this thing up before.
Oh, he even got the hat, too. I just realized that now. Oh, the details he go into this game. So right now, Jaren is in the lead. He moved 2 places forward, and no other player has happened to get their pegs out from the home base. So right now, it is promising. Oh, Swan's going for another maneuver. Oh, but wouldn't you know everything?
We see a cheat move there done by the man.
I can't believe it. Now let's take a look at this replay. Here, Swan thinks, you know what? I'm going to end Jaren's streak. Pops the die and bam! Everything spills right on the table.
I guess anything to win on this cost.
Now, I really do feel sorry for all the other guys, because then they have to remember where all the pigs are.
It's a smart move, though. Jaren can forget all his pigs were even on the board and put him back in home.
That is true, Xanadu. And so, let's see. Everyone's trying to put everything back.
Let's see if Swan does the honest thing and puts Jaren back in the game.
He does. He does.
What a loser.
Oh, but look at this, Xanadu. Jaren's pig has actually moved a spot further, closer to base.
He should have been disqualified on that one.
I'm not sure if Swan ever caught that, but right now everybody's okay with it and they're going to continue the game.
Well, he's so colorblind, I bet he can only see red.
Jaren moved his 4-3. Again, he's still in the lead. Aaron is still stuck at home.
I call a conspiracy on this one.
Absolutely, Xanadu. I mean, never have I ever seen such a slow start ever in this game.
Well, he has the green, so that means go.
And so far, all we're having is reds, but none of them are on the board. Okay. Oh, and right there, Jaren's first peg is at the safe zone. So right now, again, it's looking good for Jaren. And Aaron's still stuck at 5.
It's only the beginning of the game.
Only in the beginning, folks. Oh, boy.
If he's the only one that moves, I'm
going to
kill him.
So, right there, Thomas is stuck. Oh!
And then we got to start off at the 6.
Unbelievable. And then he moves forward, too. A bit of a slow start, but then again, it's something.
But the point is, he fired out of the gate when it mattered.
Yes.
Jaren taking the cowardly way out of that one.
And Aaron is still stuck.
Except you.
Thomas. Hoping to turn this game around. Nope. A sign of frustration.
He's nerd raging, and there goes Swan with 3.
2 3s. Is that right?
He's free once again.
Again, Aaron showing his disappointment there.
Speaking of Jaren, I heard after he rolls 6s, he doesn't go again. What kind of guy doesn't know the rules to the game?
Well, I think in technical terms, it's considered him being a noob.
Okay. Yeah, there you go.
Oh, what a sad thing. Didn't he not have a childhood?
Yeah, I know, right?
I guess not. I guess trouble
wasn't.
Look at
that. You saw that Thomas tried cheating but putting him a step forward.
Oh, good eye there, Xanadu. Well, at least he got everything squared away. And a good roll for Swan as he got a 6 and a 4. That's a really big leap there.
I know he didn't go for the risky move and bring in another piece off, but it's just too much with that Thomas guy around there.
And Jaren moves forward with 6. I'm surprised that
he
didn't.
And he takes him out.
Yes. So here we go. He moves his forward 6 paces and returns Swan back at home. A really gutsy move, because I could have sworn that since he got another 6,
he would have put another guy out there.
That's right.
Why is that over there? Oh, no, that doesn't work over there.
Nope. Swan's cheating didn't work
at
all.
No, he's too much of an honest guy. That's what the problem with that kid is.
Absolutely.
No guts. He should have went for the cheat.
So Jaren goes again, moves forward 4 paces.
With just Thomas on the field, it is a scary game.
Very scary, and unfortunately, Aaron is still stuck.
Wow. Speaking of one, wow.
Thomas just inching his way slowly. Oh, but Swan is still stuck, unfortunately. On Aaron's turn, he got a 1. Again, still no momentum there, Xanadu. Everyone is speechless, including us.
I don't want to put it because I'm scared of him now.
So Thomas got another 6. It looks like he took another player out, and he moves forward 4 paces. A really smart move, and something that we would absolutely recommend when you're playing this game.
Just go for it, Jaren. Go for it. Go ahead, kill us.
It's too easy. Swan gets a 2. Jaren.
I think Aaron is the underdog in this. He can come back and wipe everyone out.
Absolutely. There's Xanadu. It's Aaron's turn. Oh, but not this time. He has to wait a little bit more because he got a 2.
God, he's that close to me.
Thomas gets a 3, which peacefully
moves. Now, Alex, this is a weird move on Thomas.
How so, Xanadu?
He is right there for the picking.
Absolutely right. Oh. Then again, he gets to save himself as Swan is unable to move. But look at that. Aaron is free once at last. And look at that. He turns the game around by sending Jaren back.
Jaren called that number 2.
Here we go on the replay. Aaron rolls a 6, and the timing could not have been better. Right there, pops a die up in the air, gets a 1, and sure enough, Jaren's in the way, therefore Jaren goes back. What a turnaround. And obviously Jaren is reeling from the mistakes that he has made before. But the good news is he still has one peg of his own that's still out there and still trying to get into the safe zone.
But Thomas, on the other hand, is the giant risk here.
Absolutely. I would not want to be that close to Swan's red starting position.
Well, not only that, look at that. There's 2 spaces behind for Jaren.
Oh, that absolutely right, Xanadu. So Aaron moves forward at 4. There's still a really huge gap between him and Jaren, so he's safe. But Thomas is able to take another piece out, and he goes for 4 pieces, and he sends Jaren back to the home base. What a turnaround there, Xanadu. Here we go, Jaren. Takes the 6. Here we see it again. Brings out a 4. Jaren's in the way. Jaren, unfortunately, your guy gets sent back and you are stuck in the limbo this time.
I guess do not pass go. Do not collect $200 on
this. Nope. He is going broke on this one.
God, darn it.
And Jaren can't hide his frustrations there. Oh, and look at that. It's another 6. He gets to go again, and he moves his guy forward 1, clearing up the field so he could make room for more guys to join in on the game.
It's a 2-on-3 switcheroo going on here.
Absolutely. There's Xanadu. Thomas is wavering. But he says, I'm going to go for it. Brings his guy out to the start and moves the 4th peg in. Yet he's still in dangerous zone because Swan, if he were to get free, there's at least 1 peg of Thomas that is in the way. Jaren's a bit irritated there.
I would too. He had 1 peg at home and only 3 in the base.
Oh, absolutely. Oh, and look at that. Aaron moves his guy closer. Thomas, he is unfortunately within range of being attacked. But it doesn't matter there. Thomas gets a 5 and he tries to get a step ahead in front of Aaron and perhaps Swan if he gets free. Nope, Swan is still trapped. Jaren, still trapped into his home base. But Aaron gets another 6. Would you look at that? And he goes forward 4 paces again, trying to free his guy up from the starting zone.
Now this is where Thomas should just be taking all those pieces back home.
Absolutely. Oh, but he got to 6 right there. Goes again. Oh, unfortunately he couldn't get the biggest leap that he would want to on that one. Up next is Jaren. Oh, but he gets a 6. He didn't have to wait too long.
If there's a 2, I'll be mad.
Oh, it's a 5. He leaps over Thomas, but he's trailing right behind Aaron. What's Aaron going to do here?
He can take out that 1 piece. I'm so sorry. That 1 peg more. And he does.
Oh, yeah. He spotted Thomas's peg, and he sent Thomas back home.
Like, okay, I feel bad. Watch. This one's going to like turn into a 1.
Right now, Thomas is doing fine because he's thinking, you know, it's okay. I still got 3 guys left on the board.
Oh, and he cursed Swan with the 1 there, Alex.
Absolutely. Swan still is unable to move. Oh. Aaron gets a 3. What's he going to do now?
He can get Thomas.
Oh, and he saw it.
And he does.
He read your mind there, Xanadu, and he sends Thomas back.
Now it looks like things are slowing down for Thomas on the go.
Absolutely. 2 guys are in play on behalf of Thomas, whereas Aaron still has 3 of his guys out there on the game
board. But we're not paying attention to Jaren, who has 1 piece in the home.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, of course. When you're in the safe zone, I mean, that's really one of your lowest priority. You are more concerned about the guy that's actually trying to circle around and get into that safe zone. Oh, Aaron is free. He didn't have to wait too long, and he gets to move forward 6, which won't really move.
And
he counts
does,
away. Yeah.
He counts it away. And he gets Jaren rid of out. Jaren.
Oh, he is dominating the game board. So here again, right there on the replay.
That's like watching the Patriots and the Falcons again. It's coming back.
Yes, absolutely. There's that to do. There we go. He gets another six. His luck could not have been better.
Look, he even does the slow 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 count, and he goes for it.
That's right. Always good to keep a mind of who's at play and how far you are between your pieces and the other opponent's pieces. So now he gets to go again. He moves forward 4. That's a pretty safe zone there, wouldn't you say?
Yeah,
so?
But he's also closing in on Thomas there.
That's right.
And Thomas has a chance of getting rid of 3 of those pieces.
Oh, look
and
at that.
Look at that.
It's a jam. Oh!
I seen a little push there. I can tell he cheated.
There's been a little bit of nudge there. I am not going to dispute that one, Xanadu. Look at that. Swan is finally
goes
free.
Again.
He goes again. Gets a 4. Oh.
And he's between 2 dangerous spots.
Either he will eat someone or he will be eaten by someone else.
And,
hey!
And he misses it.
Absolutely. So Swan was in a safe spot as Aaron sends Thomas back to home. And Thomas unfortunately has just one guy out there in play.
Now
oh!
he's back. But this game's all about risk.
Absolutely.
Even though the game's...
Well, troubling series. Well... Series of troubling events through dice.
Yes.
Yeah.
Now that's a bad move for Swan. He needs more pieces out there.
Absolutely. I'm pretty sure when this game is over, you're going to be heckling him good.
We'll see. It's still early.
That's right. So Aaron, unfortunately, can't get that much momentum. He moves one pace forward. Thomas, on the other hand, gets a really good roll there.
And he's closing in on Aaron.
That's right. I wouldn't want to be in Aaron's shoes in the next turn. He better hope that the Thomas actually gets a low number or a number big enough that could actually skip over his piece. So Aaron gets a 4. Oh, opening the gap
and
is a really good
move. And
it's
back to the same position
absolutely.
They were earlier.
Oh, you're absolutely right there, Xanadu. I didn't realize that Swan's red piece is in between a yellow and a blue one. So let's see what Thomas does next.
Well, Thomas is trying to corner in. I don't know if that's a smart way of doing things.
Exactly. Swan moves forward 4.
And does he? Yes. He misses.
He misses. Oh, wait a minute.
No, wait.
He's retracing
his
steps.
There's a recount.
Count him out.
And no, he hits it.
He sends Aaron back home. I'm pretty sure my brother isn't really happy about that. It stings a little.
Well, Alex, he still has 3. That's the part we're not looking at. He shouldn't be too unhappy about that.
Right, you are, Xanadu. So here we go. Swan realizing, hey, wait a minute, I missed a spot.
The Boy Scout actually goes 1 back instead of 4, putting him in the lead of winning.
Exactly.
What a goody two-shoes.
So Jaren is still stuck in 4. Aaron gets a 1. Ooh, trying to close in the gap with Thomas.
Now Thomas might be aiming for Swan and Aaron on this roll.
Absolutely, there's Xanadu.
Nope,
oh, he gets
he
a 2.
Catches up.
What will he do?
I don't trust me doing this. This is risky.
So he sends his guy over at the starting position. Now if Aaron rolls a 6, it will be all over for Thomas.
Now there is a bad move for Swan. He's behind 2 people. Aaron has him locked in, Alex.
That's right, there's Xanadu. Here we go. Oh, good break there for Thomas as Aaron cannot bring the extra piece from the home base back to the starting position. So then he decides to close in the gap on Thomas once again, and hopefully he'll tell him enough just to send that piece back. Thomas gets a 3.
But that puts him in the middle of 2 different positions.
That's right.
Look at that. He has 2 pieces from Aaron and 1 from Swan. Let's see if Swan can pull off a miracle, and he does.
Nice. He sends Aaron back to home. Now Aaron is just down to 2 pegs in the board.
I don't know. Something tells me he's going to be paying for that.
Oh, we got a Jedi.
And Swan does something to mess with Jaren.
That is unbelievable.
There
clearly,
was a 6 that was about to be rolled on that. I seen it.
Yeah, there's no trick photography here. Clearly in the frame, we can see Swan's hand giving the game board a good shake in getting that number up to 4.
But Aaron is safe with 1 piece in the can.
Absolutely.
And Thomas has a 5. What will he do? He's going to corner in down on that blue peg.
He did corner in.
All right, and Swan's trying to escape a little bit easily. Swan not too bad of a space, but not too good either.
Thomas allowed
allow me to have that turn.
I would have.
Now, you can't help but wonder what Jaren is thinking at this point, as he, last time I checked, he has not gotten any sixes so far.
Now, I just heard an interesting conversation about something about another game and how Thomas would have let Swan cheat. Huh. What game does that bring up?
Let's see.
I guess it sounds like a practice game.
Yeah, a practice game?
Yeah.
Oh, finally, Jaren is free. Big sigh of relief.
How long
there.
Will he be free for? Is the question. Look, I'm not sure.
Not a big leap there, Xanadu. You can't help but feel a little bit frustrated if you were in Jaren's shoes.
At least Aaron's trying to get around that border, get a nice space between both guys.
Absolutely, that's the name of the game. If I was in,
I thought
Aaron's
the name
shoes,
of the game. Alex, I think you got to go back to reading class.
No. The name of the game is the series of troublesome events through dice.
That sounds like a mouthful.
Yeah, it is. It really is. But what can I say? We're not the ones who invented this game.
We should have been.
Right. So here we go on Aaron's turn. Oh, he gets a six, gets to go again. Oh, not a really big leap there, Xanadu.
No, but not the big leap, but he's away from Thomas a little more.
Thomas is okay, contemplating. Oh, he's got the two.
And he gets him.
Oh, wouldn't you look at that. Aaron, after thinking that he could sigh some breath of release. Relief, not release. Thomas, sure enough, gets a
and
two.
And Swan clears that one piece off of there, Alex. I don't mean to interrupt you on that, but I just wanted to clear that up.
Absolutely. So he is now safe with one pig.
Imagine if he took us all
in there. Aaron gets a five. A pretty good leap there, but it kind of leaves him vulnerable.
Aaron's doing something smart. He's moving away, leaving the fight to Thomas and Jaren.
Absolutely. There's Xanadu. Thomas moves forward four. That just leaves
him. He's almost there.
Yep, roughly two spots away from the safe zone.
Now, if Jaren can get a good move, he can clear that piece and keep Thomas at the one.
That is correct, Xanadu.
Now, Swan's back down to the slow start.
Oh, you want to talk about slow starts? So Jaren only got a two there. Aaron leaps for a three.
Aaron's the one that's going to be safe here. I think he might take this game home. I don't know.
All he needs is those big numbers, and then he'll be back in business.
I mean, double six, he's there.
That's right. Thomas gets
in there.
Yep, now he got two pigs in the safe zone. So right now Thomas is leading two, and everyone else is trailing with one.
Oh, there's another piece.
Swan gets free at six. He moves forward four. Oh, just skips over one spot of Aaron's. Really
good
break.
Not a good place to be.
Good break for Aaron, but not a good place to be if you are Swan. Oh,
and he's sadly been missed.
Yeah, exactly. He moves forward three. That's a really good break there for Swan.
I mean, even if either of these guys lose, they got to think about it. At least they had a point.
That's right there, Xanadu. But Thomas, unfortunately, can't move anymore.
That's true.
But now you are shenanigans.
Oh, here we see on that replay.
Another instant replay here, huh?
Hey, we got another switcheroo here.
Uh-oh. And there it went.
Yep. Swan moves forward two paces, and then he sends Aaron back home. Unfortunately, that means Aaron is stuck until he can roll another six. Jaren gets one, a little bit irritated that he's only skipping when he should be running.
It's a slow start indeed, and he's dying out fast.
Thomas, he can't help but feel a little bit frustrated. All he can do is move his guy up into the safe zone there, Xanadu.
These are very low number rolls, and I believe we're mid-game already.
Absolutely.
Swan gets a break on Jaren, though. He could have put out another piece that puts him away.
Aaron, unfortunately, is stuck. It goes back to Thomas. Can he free a piece? Nope, unfortunately, he is stuck as well. Swan goes in.
And he has a five.
It's
wow.
A five. A really big leap, and that's the sort of thing that you want in this game.
And there goes Jaren again with low numbers.
Really low.
These guys are playing Mario Party now. These guys need to learn their games.
Well, Swan just confessed that had he been playing Mario Party and lose, he would be the kind of guy that would reset the game and just ruin everyone's fun. Oh. Typical heelish maneuver, wouldn't you say so, Xanadu?
Yeah, but I think he's just trying to play mind games that aren't working.
Oh, that's a pretty good leap there for Jaren. He gets a 4. Aaron is unfortunately still stuck, but he moves his piece forward 1 in the safe zone.
I don't know why he's even moving a piece up there, Alex. He's safe.
Well, he might as well if he can't move any other piece that's still in play except that one.
Mm-hmm. True.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, Jaren.
Jaren, what's he going to do?
He's going to go for it?
No, this is something I could not really understand what he was going to do. Like, he was actually thinking, should I move forward 6? But considering that he's behind Thomas, I would put in as many game pieces on the board as I can.
And this is where Swan's safe. Jaren's jumping in there. He's trying to get back in the line.
Absolutely. And Aaron just happened to free himself, and he moves forward 5. Thomas, on the other hand,
cannot get the ground rolling.
Absolutely not there, Xanadu. Oh, but look at that. Swan is closing in on the gap between himself and Aaron.
I think he's just trying to escape Jaren.
That's a really good one there, Xanadu. But Jaren is looking pretty good. He got now 2 pieces into the safe zone, so him and Thomas are right now tied, and he still has one more piece on play.
Is it me, or do you feel something, Alex? Like Jaren's competitive energy just kind of tainting this game?
Yeah, well, he did have a bit of a head start there. Of course, it was the other players that kept him oppressed. We got a feeling that he did feel a bit held down, but now is his time to actually come forward and turn this whole game around. So there we go, he was forward 4. And so Aaron is looking to, well, first they reposition the board, but Aaron absolutely at this point needs to get those big numbers just so he can tie it up with Thomas and Jaren, but unfortunately he only gets to skip one spot.
And skip he does.
Thomas.
And he does not.
Does nothing. Swan on skipping. The hand. Yep, skipping away.
We're Skipsville, I'll tell you.
Jaren gets a little bit of a jog momentum there. Move forward 3, but oh, he gets himself saved as Aaron could not get a 6 that would send his green piece back. And so he has no other choice but to move his yellow piece forward by 2.
I don't know. I think Swan's the most chilled out player in this whole game.
Probably. I mean,
he doesn't even seem like he's caring about whether he gets somebody.
He has less to lose, yet more to gain. Aaron gets a 5, a pretty good break there as he starts to get the momentum rolling.
I don't know. We might have to see. I'm hoping he gets a 6 soon.
Oh, look at that. Thomas is finally free. He gets his man out there on the starting position.
And he's closing in on Swan.
That's right. But unfortunately, he only gets to hop 2 spots while Swan... And he's safe. Yep, gets his piece into the safe zone. Now, at this point, it looks like Thomas, Jaren, and Swan are tied as the leaders on this game. Aaron, unfortunately, is on the low end of this whole spectrum. He's still trying to get his second piece into the safe zone.
And look, that would have been a bad move for Swan if he wasn't there.
Absolutely, there's Xanadu. But Swan repositions his pieces.
Did you not see that little flare he tried doing with his hand?
I will admit I was mesmerized there a little bit there. Aaron gets a 1. Ah, kind of a rough position to be in. If Jaren gets a 6, unfortunately he would be locked for as long as he'll keep getting a non-6 on that die.
I don't know, even Thomas can just get in and get out real quick.
Absolutely there. Swan gets a 2, which means he can't do anything at the moment. Here comes Jaren's turn. Will he turn it around? Nope, he can only move that piece 4, which is still pretty good considering that he still has a man that has to circle around and get into that system.
But Aaron's about to get his second point, Alex.
That's right, there's Xanadu. I'm sure he's hoping to get another 6. Thomas moves forward 3.
I heard a little shout out there. That should have been taken out of the footage.
Yeah, absolutely. Such a shameless plug there from those guys. But then again, we're kind of sponsored by the...
Were they the ones that got us this game?
They're the ones that actually sponsored this whole tournament there, Xanadu.
Ah, like that means anything.
So here we go. Thomas gets a 5. A really big leap there. A really good one. Now it's Swan's turn. Can he get his piece free? Nope.
He cannot.
He is stuck. Jaren, on the other hand, only hops with a 1.
I say that Thomas might be the underestimated opponent in this one. Absolutely. We don't know, because now with Aaron out of the way, he's clear free.
Yes, Aaron now ties it up with everyone else. All players now have four pegs at home, but
this is where we gotta really think. Is Jaren the one we should be chasing with one, or is Thomas the one we should be chased with two?
Absolutely. Oh, what a risky maneuver. If Aaron gets a six, Thomas will be reduced by one peg on the board. Jaren, not fazed by the momentum, he goes forward five, but oh, really good break there for Thomas as Aaron did not get a six on that one.
Thomas is close.
That's right. Oh, very smart. He wants to get that third piece into the safe zone. He wants to lead in on this board. So it looks like Jaren, he gets a four. It's starting to round it. He's not that far away, too, from the safe zone there, Xanadu.
I don't know. Six can come up anywhere and anytime.
He gets a five. There's only one piece that can move.
Absolutely. See what I'm saying?
Yep, you are right there, Xanadu.
Well, let's see if someone can tie him out. Nope.
No, nope. Swan, Swan. Nope. Absolutely stuck.
Not in my game.
Jaren.
Whoa, some cockiness thrown by Jaren.
Absolutely right. Aaron is absolutely stuck.
Jaren shouldn't be talking, though. He only has one piece out versus Thomas, who has two.
Absolutely. I mean, he still has one man in home base, so if I was in Jaren's shoes, I wouldn't get my hopes up yet. Swan! Oh, it looks like a six, but nope, it's a five, which means he is stuck. Jaren's turn. Let's see what number he'll get. But right now, it looks like everyone is just amping up their own mind games, you know, just trying to get into each other's head and psych-talk everyone else.
Well, I don't know about that Jaren guy. It seems like he's not even paying attention to the people on the board.
Absolutely
He
not.
Thinks it's just him playing himself. Alex, where can we find these guys?
Well, they did advance into the finals, so they were given the invitations, and it was through their luck that they got here.
That's where you're wrong. We got nothing but car troubles and disqualifications off the wide. Where is the advancements by fair play?
Hence
oh,
the
and there
luck.
We go.
Oh, look
and
at that.
And there went Thomas.
So let's take a look on this replay. So Swan gets a lucky break. There goes the six. Thomas is not looking good.
It didn't look like he was going for Thomas, though, if you think about it.
Well, at this point, there's only one way he can go in. Unfortunately, Thomas is in
his
way.
It wasn't Thomas' direction.
I knew it, too. I knew it. I was like,
you should have begged it like that. We're friends.
So despite Thomas's begging, it just didn't help him out. He still got one guy sent back to home.
I see Jaren trying to cheat in his move, trying to move on a two.
Either that or he's just really lost. So Thomas, just barely away from the safe zone. He's not technically in there just yet.
Look at that. He just dodged Jaren. Jaren just dodged Swan. There is a collision avoided here.
Absolutely.
Swan catches the break. It's on his side. Aaron ain't getting anything.
Nope, he is still stuck in. I wonder how long will his bad luck last.
As long as people think I'm Adam West.
Good one there, Xanadu.
And look, Swan goes for that two melee pieces, and he takes the two jump.
Absolutely. This is a really good break there for Swan, as all of his pieces are in play, and Jaren
smoke no cigar.
Nope. Oh, what was that?
What was that?
Numbers?
I think so. And there goes Thomas with double pieces back, and he moves up the four.
You know, now that I think about it there, Xanadu, both guys are so excited about playing the game. They're probably doing a live Facebook feed or maybe taking a picture that they could post on Instagram.
Sad riding on the coattails of the rave corner.
Unbelievable.
Not in our house. And there goes Aaron with the break. He gets a two jump, skipping, but he's going.
Then again, I think we should speak fondly because the rave corner is one of the many sponsors of this tournament.
Uh-oh.
So at this point,
home,
yes, absolutely, they're Thomas. You know, Xanadu,
and he skips it.
I can't believe that Thomas actually had to think about this. I mean, if I was in Thomas's shoes, the right thing to do would be to get as many pieces as you can into that safe zone.
Well, Superman, yes, but no super brains. Look at that, and I'm glad he sent it home because you would have ate him out with that, Aaron, if you could hear me. You got that, Alex?
Absolutely. I really do hope that Aaron got what our messages were.
I feel like there's I'm the right there in that game though. Jaren looks like he's getting frustrated silently.
He is definitely cringing.
The talk really stopped, apparently.
So Aaron had no momentum there, could only move forward in one pace. But Thomas, on the other hand, he's looking very good. He rolled a 5 there, Xanadu.
I don't know. It looks like he's trying to be blocked away.
Oh, well, Jaren, all he could do is just move his guy up a peg in the safe zone there. Thomas goes for a 3. Still looking good, though, Xanadu.
Oh, and there's a bad move. It's a bad spot to be for Swan.
Absolutely. Oh, but Jaren is still stuck, looking good for all the other players. Aaron is finally free. He gets a 6. Gets a roll again, and he moves forward 4.
He's closing in.
Absolutely.
Thomas has some obstacles to jump and cross over.
So right now, Thomas has got to be very nervous. He has 3 pegs in the safe zone, and he's just down 1. So he is leading
and
on the board.
And Swan sends Aaron home, Alex.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable.
For the sake of getting out of there.
And he just freed himself, too, but it's okay. He's still got
and
one piece
he sends
board.
Swan home. A 2-for-1, eye-for-an-eye play, I see there.
Absolutely. Oh, and with that, the game will conclude after a quick word from our sponsors.
Follow Maui Comics and Collectibles on Facebook and Instagram. It's packed with books and other cool stuff, but it's nothing like a library. They got comic books, and they got cool guys who won't shush you when you talk. For figure reviews and more, check out The Rave Corner. Also available on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Aaron is cool. You know, he gave me $3 once to buy myself a smoothie, and it was good! If you want a 60-second review on a movie, check out Jaren's Movie Reviews on Instagram. Hashtag Jaren's Movie Reviews. Viewers demanded more substance, so now they got it. Spoiler alert, there are no spoilers. For horror and science-related topics, check out Friday Night Frights on YouTube at youtube.com/wolfhouse808. There you will see Tony Midnight, Killer Cal, and Ali V, along with various guests such as Jaren, Aaron, Swan, Maui Mark, The House of Blues, and even Al Jawa. Hell, Al Jawa's cool. You know, the next time you see him, tell him to play his little Zelda Piccolo. Woo! Check out Marco's comic book collection hauls and more on YouTube. Man, this guy's cool. He kind of reminds me of Seuss from Gravity Falls. Although he says bro a lot instead of dude. And that's for all of our sponsors for today. Let's get back to the game.
And we're back. So right now we have Thomas and Jaren leading on the board with 3 pegs in the safe zone.
Jaren is very frustrated. I see that 5 didn't please him.
Absolutely. There's Xanadu. And Swan and Aaron is absolutely tied in last place as both pegs are
now,
in the
season. Now, before our commercial break, for those who are just joining us, Swan did eat Aaron's yellow, and Aaron took a little vengeance, Alex, on his red piece.
That's right. It's that old saying, turnabout is fair play.
Yes.
So right now, Thomas, if you could see on the bottom left of your screen, you just got that last peg that's away by 2 paces.
Well, Thomas thinks that he's going to have to go around again.
What an imbecile. That's all I can say.
Did you not hear that? He said, it looks like if since I'm blocked there, I have to go around the board one more time.
I'm pretty sure all the players wouldn't mind.
Yes, I don't think so either. I think we should have let that be a rule.
But unfortunately, our official Alika, he had to set Thomas straight and say, no, man, you got to head straight to the safe zone.
That Alika, I'd like to see someone get tough with him one day. We know that ain't going to happen.
Nope.
Thomas ain't getting any nowhere. I think everyone's just trying to close in on Thomas. And Jaren misses big time.
Absolutely. A missed opportunity there by Jaren. Aaron is far away from closing in on Thomas. He only gets forward at 3. Oh.
Thomas has a 1.
Which means his peg should
can jump up.
It should move up 1, Thomas. Thomas.
He doesn't know what he's
doing. He doesn't know. All
and
right.
He let Swan have the little glory that could have been his. Jaren's still upset about that swing and the miss he took at taking
absolutely
Thomas down, and I bet he's going to pay for it. It's Thomas.
Thomas goes.
6.
He gets 6, gets to go again.
And he has a 1.
He has a 1. He finally realizes that
this game could have been his last turn.
Been
we
over.
Need a 6 No, we got a two from Swan. He skips it, and he misses two of his opportunities.
Had Thomas move his piece forward one, as he did on his previous
This game turn, would have been over.
It would have been over a long time ago. A missed opportunity there.
And then that's the game.
That is over.
That's the way the cookie crumbles.
Thomas is your champ. Let's take a look at the finishing blow. He gets a six, goes again. It's a one, and of course, he sees it. We all sees it. It's
the
over.
The Superman fan got super duped earlier. And we see Swan going for the quick cheat.
Yes, he's trying to do the turnaround, but at this point, it's way too late. There's nothing to do. Congratulations, Thomas.
Although, Alex, Thomas managed to struggle a little bit, he still managed to pull off the win for the big prize.
We are now joined by our professional player analyst, Joseph. Joseph, what did you think about this game?
Well, I thought Thomas was really impressive. It looked like the other guys had an ample amount of time to turn things around, but they were just ultimately caught in the circle of a board game. Although Thomas had a really good comeback, kind of like a competitive eater, loosening his belt while he finished his giant ice cream sundae.
Well, let's go down to my brother AJ, who is at the table and is now interviewing the big winner.
Thanks, guys. All right, Thomas, by virtue of winning the tournament, I hereby grant you the grand prize, which is a free coupon for bragging rights. Feel free to show it off to the camera.
Boo! AJ Thomas!
We're going to build a wall.
My goodness. So, what were your thoughts leading into this match?
Leading into this match, I thought I was going to lose because the last time someone else won, but thank goodness that didn't happen.
All right, so during the entire game, were you ever once worried? What kind of strategy did you use to win this match?
This strategy I used, may the force be with me.
All right, so leading up to the next year's
and
tournament,
also
is
with
there
you.
Any sort of special training that you are going to do?
A lot of lonely nights. I just keep on doing that. Can't keep it.
All right. So.
And we wonder why you're single.
I know, right?
All right, so with that said, let's go back to the booth. Thomas, thank you.
Thank you.
12 contestants have been entered, and only one managed to become the big winner and win the big prize, which is one free bragging rights coupon.
I really enjoyed this tournament, Alex. I hope to see everyone at the next one.
All right, and on behalf of everyone on the series of Troublesome Events Through Dice, we would like to...
Hold on, Alex. We're being told that Killer Cal and Tony Midnight have something to say to the victor, and this ridiculous because we have 10 seconds, we officially can't do it.
Well, you're right, Xanadu, but apparently my brother AJ has been summoned, so let's just go down and see what's happening. Take it away, AJ.
Thanks, guys. I am joined by Killer Cal and Tony Midnight, who apparently has something to say to the winner.
The winner? Who the hell? You know, who the hell this...
Well, that's all the time we have for you today. On behalf of the series of Troublesome Events Through Dice, I'm Alex.
I'm Xanadu.
I'm Joseph.
Thank you all for tuning in, and so long.
Goodbye, everyone. Woo! Woo! Woo!